This is MSN, the Mountaineers Sports Network. Welcome to the Louisville edition of MSN Replay, presented by Shoney's. I'm Woody O'Hara. Let's get right to the action. The Cardinals jumped on the board early as Michael Bush went in from 5 yards out. After a field goal, Louisville built its lead to 17-0 with 7 seconds left in the half. We pick up the action on West Virginia's first drive of the second half.
Out of the gun, two receivers right, two receivers to the left. And Bednarik takes the snap, blitz comes, he dumps the ball right flat, and it is caught, and starting upfield is Slayton. He spun around at the 15 and gains 5 ahead to the 17-yard line.
That's a start, that's 5, now we need 15.
Left side cornerback, Rod Council, redshirted freshman who started 2 weeks ago for the first time against Oregon State. Had a big game against Oregon State with 7 tackles, made the stop there, 3rd down and 15. Twin receivers out to each side from the shotgun. Scrimmaging from the 17-yard line. Bednarik ready. Dan Moses snaps the ball back. Adam drops, and he steps up. He's got field ahead of him. Looks downfield. Pump fakes, and now he's going to get thrown down. He will be tackled, and we'll have penalty flags thrown. Holding Louisville. Sophomore quarterback Bednarik takes the snap, drops the throw, blitz comes, he will fire a ball, and the pass is caught at the 40-yard line for a first down, and a flag comes down at the point of the tackle, hauled in by Raynaud. Interference against Louisville. Receiver to each side, conventional snap from center, and the snap, and Moses snaps back to Bednarik, who hands off to Slayton up the sideline, 45, shoulder down, and he'll pick up a nice chunk. About 8, no, they're going to give him about 9, and very close to a first down run for Steve Slayton. My goodness, he might have it. He does have the first down. Very nice spot. Let's bring that guy with us all the time. Council, the cornerback, again making the tackle. West Virginia down 17-0. It's opening possession of the second half. They have the ball at the 50-yard line. Right side of the field to the right. Single receiver to each side, straight eye. Bednarik handing off, Slayton looking for room, cuts it up to the middle, and he'll take it to the 45 to the 44, a 6-yard gain.
Nice job there, Tony. He started the stretch play and then found a nice cutback seam. Hit back up over what would have been about the right guard.
Josh Bailey, tight end, injured, comes limping off of the field, and he'll be replaced by Mike Villagrana. Bailey coming off his best blocking game as a Mountaineer last Saturday against Rutgers. Second down and 4. Backs are split and offset. Receiver right and a receiver left. Slayton in the backfield along with Owen Schmidt. And on second down and 4, handoff goes to Slayton. He finds the seam. Here he goes. 40, 35 to the sideline, 30, down the sideline, 25. Picks out a tackler and takes it inside the 20 all the way down to the 18-yard line. And here come the Mountaineers. Steve Slayton goes for 26 yards.
Nice job. Good job up front. Good job up front. Really nice job stretching that also by Steve. He really saw some inside support. It looked like he was going to take it up inside, but bounced it all the way around the widest block. Good job.
17-0 Louisville on top. West Virginia looking to get on the board. First and 10 from the 18. Again, it's Slayton, again up the middle inside to the 15-yard line and down to the 14. Another chunk of 4 for the freshman running back.
4 is good. We'll take 4. That keeps us on that first down track. That's what we need to do.
Steve Slayton has gained 46 yards on this drive. Darrell Jallo wide out to the right. Brandon Miles to the left. Backs are split and staggered behind Adam Bednarik. Second and 16 from the Louisville 14-yard line. Under center, Bednarik takes a snap, play actions, pocket collapses. He throws incomplete in the end zone for Miles. And the pass was short of the mark. He got hit and hit hard upon releasing that football and really never had a great chance to throw that ball the way he wanted to and set his feet.
Yeah, it looked like he got his arm hit at the release there and got it, just that whole thing collapsed. But he did have an open receiver. The call was good. They're giving us some man coverage. They're walking up, giving us 8 people up there in a support position, and they walk it late. and then play a straight man, so that's why it looks pretty good.
Third and six from the 14-yard line. Shotgun, two receivers right and one left, and the snap back. Bednar, quick pass left side, flat caught by Slayton. Here he comes to the 10, to the 5, end zone, touchdown, West Virginia's Steve Slayton from 14 yards out. And the Mountaineers take the opening possession of the second half, and they march the ball down the field, and they score their first points of the afternoon.
Have you decided?
Sirloin steak fingers.
Whoa, Nelly!
Barry, you've just ordered yourself a Shoney's value basket. What's your game plan?
Well, I ordered the sirloin steak fingers, Keith. I'm gonna eat them.
Sounds good. What about defense? Huh? You gotta be ready. This lineup brings five great All-American baskets to the table.
I'm ready, Keith.
I'm ready!
From burgers to chicken fingers, these value baskets are ready to be gobbled up. All for just $5.99. Hurry, because just like football season, they'll go away fast. For great food at a great price, it's down, set, Shoney's.
Drinking and smoking can lead to birth defects, learning disabilities, and other problems that can last a lifetime. If there's even a chance that you could be pregnant, don't wait. Stop smoking and stop drinking now. Give your baby a healthy start.
Now, watch that, watch that, watch that. I got him, I see him, I see him. Give me the ball, Pops.
Come get it.
I think that's a challenge. Are you serious?
I won't even put my bag down.
Come on, man.
Don't let that man shoot.
You got nothing. You don't got nothing.
Oh. Oh. Your mouth looks dry. Have a coke.
You know what that is? That's the rooftop, sir.
Trying to pay off a high wireless bill is never pretty. Thankfully, there's Evo, the only phone with unlimited text messaging and free night and weekend calling that lets you decide how much to spend each month. Get the signal. Cellular One.
Mountaineer Athletic Club, providing 133 scholarships to women student-athletes.
Today's game is brought to you by Shoney's. Enjoy Shoney's legendary breakfast buffet. It's a whole lot of food for your money. Shoney's. By West Virginia's Bank, United Bank. We're united with the Mountaineers. By Budweiser. Bright, crisp, clean, pure. The king of beers. By State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And by the West Virginia Lottery. Good things happen when you play. Louisville built a lead back to 17 points with another Michael Bush touchdown. We pick up the action on the second play of the fourth quarter.
First down and 10 for the Cards. Again, an I formation. And play action, and firing is Brom, wide open, Urrutia, and Urrutia is going to be spun around and brought down after an 8-yard reception to the 35-yard line. Mike Lorello making the tackle. Very, very impressive Louisville offense. They have done it on the ground, and they've done it through the air. They have amassed 375 yards of offense here today. And Dwight, 220 in the air, 155 on the ground.
That's pretty balanced, isn't it, Tony?
Yep. Second and two. Hand off Bush. Bush tries to lean forward. He'll be close to another first down.
Well, they're working the clock now. Now they're going to try to keep moving this ball, but the big thing's clock.
It will be third down. He will be short by almost a yard, three quarters of a yard. So third down. About a half yard. The way they've been going, Dwight, they might look at this as a free play.
Well, here's where they threw that pass to the tight end one time out of this set.
Snap, handoff. Bush is going to be hit, and he will be stopped short of the first down. Great surge by the line. That time, Blom lost his balance and tripped as he was going back to hand the ball off to Bush. Louisville going to go for it on fourth down and one. They are 3 of 3 on fourth down tries this afternoon. From the 34-yard line of West Virginia. They put a tight end to each side in an I formation. The snap and a play pass. Action. And Brom throws. And the pass broken up incomplete. The ball will go over on downs to West Virginia. Intended for the tight end, Gary Barnage, broken up by D. McCann. Defensive champion a week ago against Rutgers. Got his hand in there and swatted that ball down into the turf.
West Virginia will take over.
Mountaineers will have it with 12:57 left here in the fourth quarter.
After West Virginia got the ball back, Adam Bednarik was hurt when he got sacked. Pat White entered the game facing a second and 20.
White is ready. Dan Moses over the ball, snaps it back, and now it's going to be a designed run. White is hit over the 35, takes it toward the outside, still on his feet, and carries it ahead to the 40-yard line. And that'll be a pickup of 6 on the play for Pat White.
Broke some tackles there to get to that much. So I think they really do want to keep that quarterback draw alive because we're getting such a rush up through there. I mean, we're getting a big push out of this Louisville front. But, boy, right now we're looking at third and, 14?
Yep, third down and 14. Yard to make as the 44 of Louisville. Once again, out of the shotgun. Snap comes back. White rolls the pocket. In trouble. He'll throw downfield. The pass is caught. Hauled in for the first down by Darius Renaud at the 44-yard line. 16 yards on the play. Renaud with his second impressive catch of the game. And the Mountaineers with a fresh set of downs with 10:20 to go in the fourth. Antoine Sharp back there on the coverage. That'll give Pat a little confidence.
Absolutely.
Took over. It was second and 20. He picks up a first down. Now on first and 10 from the Cardinal 44 from the shotgun. Handoff goes to Slayton, and he starts upfield, and he'll take the ball ahead for a couple of yards. And now we are inside of 10 minutes to go. West Virginia will look at second down and long. Montavious Stanley. Nose tackle for Louisville made the tackle. Second and 9, same formation. Two receivers right, two receivers left from the gun with a single setback. Slayton lining up to the left of Pat White. White looks over toward the West Virginia sideline with the play call. Now he's ready to go to work on second down and 9. Snap comes back. White drops. White looks, sets, fires a deep ball. Receiver knocked down. Interference will be called. Darius Renaud was tripped by linebacker Nate Harris. It will be interference and a first down for West Virginia with 9:23 to go here. Backs are split on first down and 10. And White drops back to throw, has some time, throws the ball down the far sideline for Slayton, who makes the catch, but he's out of bounds. Beautiful grab, but the ball thrown out of bounds too far. And that will negate what was a very, very pretty catch. That was the old wheel route. They released Slayton down the right sideline, and the ball was just too wide.
Yeah, it was really well thrown right on the flag, and I think he also got kind of nudged that time, well covered. Defender kind of nudged him out of bounds, too, which is the way you do that.
On second down and 10 from the Louisville 28-yard line, West Virginia has two receivers left and one to the right.
Here comes pressure, I think, Tony.
Backs are to each side of the quarterback, White. And he takes the snap and drops, and he looks, and now he's flushed out of the pocket, giving up ground. Now he returns to his right, now throws downfield for Slayton. Jump ball, ball is incomplete and deflected. He underthrew him. Brandon Cox, defensive end, was back there on Slayton, and White could not get enough gas on that football. All he had to do was lob it far enough, and Slayton could have tracked it down. Instead, Slayton had to come back toward the ball, and he was put in the position to be a defensive back, just batting it away from Cox. Third down and 10 now from the 28. Two receivers left, one right. That's Miles from the gun. Now White looks over toward the Mountaineers' sideline. Play clock is at 12. White is ready. Here comes third down and 10. Snap back. White drops. He looks. Now fires far side, and the pass incomplete. Dorrell Jallo, the intended receiver. White took a shot upon releasing that ball. It will be fourth down and 10.
That was to the field. He threw that. He tried to look a couple places, and it ended up coming right back to the field on a flag route. But I'll tell you what, when he got hit, I mean, there could have been a face mask called on the hit he got. As he released it, the rusher grabbed him by the face mask and threw him to the ground.
So West Virginia down by 17, going for it here on fourth down and 10. From the Cardinals' 28-yard line, you hear the Louisville fans chanting defense. Empty backfield, five receivers going out, three left and two out to the short side. Snap back, White steps up. Pat White's going to run. He turns on the Jets to the 20. First down, 15, and takes it down inside the 15 of the 11. 17-yard run on fourth and 10 for White, and the Mountaineers will have the drive alive with 8:54 left here in the fourth quarter. Malik Jackson finally caught Pat White, who displayed that great speed that he has.
That makes you not want to rush three if you're Louisville right there, the way he hit that seam.
On first down and 10 from the 11. Shotgun snap back. White keeps it again. White goes to the 5, and he takes it into the 3. Quarterback snap. Quarterback keep. And it will be a nice pickup on first down of 8 yards.
That time it was a quarterback ISO where you had a lead back up through there. Got a nice block on the linebacker that gave Pat that extra little crease.
Second down and 2 from the 3-yard line. Shotgun, and the backs are split. Snap comes back, handoff goes to Steve Slayton. End zone touchdown, Slayton from 3 yards away. And with 8:16 to go here in the fourth quarter, West Virginia closes to within 11 points. It's 24-13.
This is who I am.
At United Bank, our roots in West Virginia date back to 1839. Today, we're the state's largest headquartered company, paying West Virginia taxes and providing jobs to our friends and neighbors. So it's no surprise that no matter whether we're processing a loan, helping you open a checking account, or talking about your retirement, at United Bank, West Virginia is a part of everything we do.
Tonight.
Love you.
Love you too. Okay, that's my foot.
I stay firm agent LaDonna Young Hansen. This is a true story.
We didn't know what kind of claim it was, because was it going to be an auto claim or a homeowner's claim?
Having one agent for all your insurance needs has its advantages.
And she handled all the paperwork?
In minutes.
She made the process totally painless.
Well, not totally. I mean, my
first. Okay.
Nobody takes care of you like State Farm.
Like a good neighbor.
State Farm is there.
I Tone. CityNet presents iTone. Finally, one IT solution. Voice, internet, data. One line, one bill. Small businesses across West Virginia are saving 25 to 40% on their telecommunications bills each month. Let CityNet give you a free audit of your telephone bills and find out how much you'll save. iTone. One line, one bill, one IT solution. Go to citynet.net and begin saving today.
It is 24-14, Louisville leading West Virginia by 10. Here's the pooch kickoff by McAfee. Loose ball fielded and caught by West Virginia. Penalty marker will be thrown on the play.
There's no penalty on the play. The block was legal because the ball had gone 10 yards at the time of the block. First down.
First down, West Virginia with a sky kick. It was recovered by the Mountaineers, and the Mountaineers down 10 with 8:16 to go. We'll have the ball inside Louisville territory. Shotgun formation with two receivers to the left and one out to the right. A running back to each side of Pat White. Dan Moses over the ball, snaps it back. Handoff goes to Slayton off the right side. Here he's at the midfield mark. 45, 40, 35, 30. Spinning down to the 29-yard line goes Steve Slayton. 22 yards on the carry for the true freshman, Slayton. And West Virginia has a first and 10. They'll put him back to the 30-yard line officially.
First down, West Virginia.
8:08 left here in the fourth quarter.
His speed got him through the line of scrimmage that time, Tony. And then you get him in the open field, it's great. But it was a little crack he had to hit, and he hit it quick.
Fully loaded shotgun handoff again goes to Slayton. Slayton takes the ball ahead inside the 30, 25 down to the 23-yard line. A 7-yard pickup for Steve Slayton. Brandon Sharp, the safety, came up to make that tackle. It will be second down and 3. Jeremy Bruce, the true freshman, checks in as a receiver. The Mountaineers go with 4 wideouts. Slayton's the lone running back, lines up to the right of Pat White. On second down and 3 from the 23, the snap back, and it's going to be a quarterback run. Here comes Pat White, and he's going to be hit and dropped a yard short of the first down at the 21-yard line. It will be third down and a yard. Brandon Johnson, senior weak side linebacker, made that tackle. 7 minutes, 10 seconds, and ticking here in the fourth quarter. West Virginia down 10, 24-14. Now the I formation by the Mountaineers. Flanker right, split end left. Snap, handoff, Slayton. First down and more inside the 15 to the 13-yard line. And he'll stop the clock on the first down run with 6:53 to go. This drive began at the West Virginia 48. They've taken it to the Cardinals 14-yard line.
Nothing but just old Smash Mouse out there right now, Tony. Taking it right to Louisville.
Twins right, single receiver left. Fully loaded shotgun formation on first and 10. Back it comes. Handoff goes to Slayton, looking to turn the corner left. Finds the seam. Flag down inside the 10. Down to the 9-yard line, but a marker is thrown, or you're going to get a holding call. Slayton lines up to the right of Pat White. Here's the snap option. Pat's going to keep it. Pat to the 15. Pat takes it to the left side at the 10. Running to the 5. End zone. Touchdown. Pat White from 23 yards away, but there is a penalty flag thrown. A penalty flag is down. Holding again against West Virginia negates the penalty, negates the touchdown. All right. Last week against Rutgers, West Virginia scored on 2 plays. 1 was taken away. Let's see if they can do it again. First down and 11 from the 15-yard line. From the shotgun, Pat White drops. Pat White looks, dumps the ball, caught by Brandon Miles. Miles takes it to the 10, and he takes it inside to the 8-yard line. 7-yard gain, the clock winding now inside of 6 minutes to go. Our score, Louisville 24, West Virginia 14. It will be second down and 4. Mountaineers over the football, shotgun. Twin receivers out to each side. Slayton to the right of Pat White. And the snap back, Pat White gonna have a quarterback keep here, and he's not gonna make that first down mark. They'll blow it dead. After a 1-yard pickup, and that clock is winding now with 5 minutes and 34 seconds and winding. West Virginia will face third down here. Line of scrimmage will be the 7. 2 receivers right and 1 out to the left. Running back to each side of Pat White. Dan Moses over the ball. Pat White looks back over toward the sideline. Play clock is at 10. On third down and 3 from the Louisville 7-yard line. White is ready, takes the snap, handoff Owen Schmidt. Here comes Schmidt, he keeps the load going. He will be stopped short though. It'll be fourth down as he takes the ball down to the 5.5-yard line, a yard short. Play clock's at 5, it's to 4. May trying to draw him off sides here. Now he's ready to go to work. And now he'll step back, and West Virginia we'll get a delay of game call. Pat McAfee is going to come on with 4:39 left here and attempt the field goal. His first try of the afternoon. Pat is 6 of 11 on the season. George Schell, the holder, will put the ball down at the 18-yard line. It will be a 28-yard field goal try from the far side hash mark. 28-yard field goal try. Mountaineers down by 10. Snap comes back. The kick goes up, and that kick is good. And West Virginia draws to within 7 points with 4:35 left.
This MSN replay of the West Virginia-Louisville game is presented by Shoney's.
Have you decided?
Sirloin steak fingers.
Whoa, Nellie! Mary, you just ordered yourself a Shoney's value basket. What's your game plan?
Well, I ordered the sirloin steak fingers, Keith. I'm gonna eat them.
Sounds good. What about defense? Huh? You gotta be ready. This lineup brings five great All-American baskets to the table.
I'm ready, Keith.
I'm ready! From burgers to chicken fingers, these value baskets are ready to be gobbled up. All for just $5.99. Hurry, because just like football season, they'll go away fast. For great food at a great price, it's down, set, Shoney's.
Sport is sport. A foul's a foul. And a bat's a bat, even if it's flat. 10 feet on the west side is 10 feet on the east side. Football is football. Unless it's football. Now, a win's a win. A loss is a loss. But no matter what, you better come with it. Because it's 90 feet to first, no matter where home is.
On any given day in West Virginia, there are enough West Virginia lottery ticket winners to fill Milan Pushkar Stadium at Mountaineer Field. That's approximately 60,000 winning tickets daily, 420,000 weekly, and more than 21 million every year. Get in the game with a West Virginia lottery. It could be your winning season.
Here we go, first and 10 for Louisville from its 20-yard line. The crowd is up. High formation for the Cardinals. Snap, toss play, right side. Here comes Michael Bush. He's going to be hit for a loss. A 2-yard loss on the play. Eric Wicks and Mark Magro there to put the stop on Michael Bush. It will be second down and 12 as the clock winds inside of 4 minutes and 20 seconds. 24-17 the score. Louisville leads by 7. Dangerous Joshua Tinch is on the field. He's caught 11 balls here this afternoon. Second and 12. Watch for number 9. Out of the shotgun. Brom is ready. And he drops to throw. Blitz comes. Pius deflected and incomplete. Deflected. Intended for Michael Bush. Lorello and Magro flying upfield. Got their hands on it. It will be third down and 12. Clock stops with 3:54 to go.
Again, Tony, that's the one thing we've done a nice job of. Our guys have gotten their hands up. We batted quite a few balls today, at least three, maybe more.
Cardinals at the line, third and 12 from their 18. Five receivers in the formation, three left, two out to the right. Brom pointing things out. He's ready. Crowd is up. Snap comes back. Blitz comes. Brom sets. He's hit. He throws the ball incomplete as he was going down. And they will rule it as an incomplete pass. The clock stops with 3:50 to go. West Virginia holds the Cardinals on three plays, and the punt team will come on for Louisville.
Fourth and 12, ball to
18. 3:50 on the clock, down by 7, West Virginia brings the punt return team on. Todd Flannery, the Cardinals punter, stands back at his 5-yard line. Snap comes back, and the kick is away. And the kick caught on the fly. Here over the 45 to the 40 is Rivers inside of the Cardinal 40-yard line. That's where West Virginia will begin the possession. Two receivers out to each side on first and 10. Shotgun for the Mountaineers. Snap back, Pat White. Option toss goes to Slayton. Slayton over the 35 to the 30. Cuts inside the 30. Keeps his feet and lunges to the 24-yard line. Steve Slayton goes for 16 yards. First down for West Virginia with 3:34 on the clock. Mountaineers down by 7, 24-17.
First down, West Virginia. First and 10.
First down and 10 from the 24. Once again, the shotgun. Two receivers right and two out to the left. Pat White ready, takes the snap, hands off to Slayton. Slayton hit in the backfield, and maybe, nope, they're not going to give him anything at all. Call that one a 2-yard loss. Lamar Miles, middle backer. makes the tackle, and that keeps that clock winding now inside of 3 minutes to go. Second down and 12 from the 25 of Louisville. West Virginia down by seven. Twins to each side once again. Snap comes back, Pat White drops. Pat White sets his feet, throws a deep ball downfield. Caught, bobbled, and incomplete by Miles.
Pat White pass.
Got his hands on it, had it momentarily inside the five, and he dropped it as he was hit by Gavin Smart, the left side cornerback, and the free safety, Brandon Sharp. It will be third down and 11 with 2:50 to go. Quickly over the ball goes Dan Moses, the center. Same formation, twins to each side. From the shotgun, Slayton lines up to the left of Pat White. White looking over toward the sideline. Mountaineers down by 7 points. Moses ready to snap, sends it back. Pressure comes, White steps up, rolls to his left, throws wide open, pass caught, first down, West Virginia. Dorrell Jallo, oh, they give him a bad spot. They bring the ball back to the 15-yard line.
Dorrell Jallo.
The clock winding now, 2:30 and ticking. He'll be a yard short of the first down. It's fourth down and a yard. Now 2:20 and winding. West Virginia will have two receivers to each side going for it. This could be the game, folks. Down by seven, fourth and a yard. Pat White looks over toward the sideline. Blitz comes. Quarterback keep. White has the first down the sideline to the 10 to the 5. He takes it down to the 3. First and goal for West Virginia with 2 minutes on the clock. A 12-yard quarterback keep off the left side for Pat White. First and goal to go for West Virginia from the 3. Mountaineers are down by 7 points, 24-17.
3-yard line.
Twin receivers out to the right, single receiver to the left. Fully loaded shotgun, Slayton and Owen Schmidt. Snap comes back, handoff goes to Slayton. Slayton up the middle, he lunges ahead and he's down to the 1 yard line, just inside the one. That keeps the clock winding now inside of 90 seconds to play. He is just inches away. West Virginia has two timeouts remaining.
Goal to go.
Big thing here on clock. We don't want to leave much time for them, Tony. We want to score, but we don't want to leave time for them. That's the big key here. So I think it's real smart letting this thing run right now. We've still got two timeouts if we need them.
All right, over the ball goes Dan Moses. Eye formation, tight end to each side. White under the center, hands the ball off. Slayton is going to be hit. He lunges ahead. He's in! Touchdown! West Virginia with exactly 1 minute to go. Slayton was hit at the line, and he reached the ball over the plane of the goal line with his arm for the touchdown. Exactly 1 minute left. West Virginia down by 1 point, 24-23, and Pat McAfee on for the extra point try. Mountaineers have scored 16 points in just over 6 minutes. And here comes the try for the tie for Pat McAfee. The snap down, the kick goes up, and the kick is good, and we are tied at 24.
Promotional consideration provided by the Charleston Department Store, your number one source for officially licensed WVU apparel.
For over 165 years, United Bank has called West Virginia home, donating millions of dollars over the years to the state's most important causes, providing business to local suppliers, and helping West Virginia businesses grow. So it's only natural that no matter whether we're opening a savings account, helping you buy a new home, or talking about your investments, at United Bank, West Virginia is a part of everything we do.
The smooth taste that gets things started. The refreshing taste that keeps things going. Where will you find the great taste of Bud Light? Wherever good friends get together. And wherever good times are going on and on. Bud Light. Great taste for your great times.
Drinking and smoking can lead to birth defects, learning disabilities, and other problems that can last a lifetime. If there's even a chance that you could be pregnant, don't wait. Stop smoking and stop drinking now. Give your baby a healthy start.
Sport is sport. A foul's a foul. And a bat's a bat, even if it's flat. 10 feet on the west side is 10 feet on the east side. Football is football. Unless it's football. Now, a win's a win. A loss is a loss. But no matter what, you better come with it. Because it's 90 feet to first. No matter where home is.
And so we will play overtime. Each team will get the football at the 25-yard line. White is ready. And the snap comes back, and the handoff goes to Owen Schmidt on first down. He breaks free. He's at the 20, to the 15, to the 10, to the 5, and he's inside the 5, takes it down to the 3-yard line. Owen Schmidt breaking tackles along the way, goes for 22 yards. It will be first down and goal for West Virginia. What a way to start the overtime session. Owen Schmidt gets his second carry of the afternoon. He was hit at the line of scrimmage, breaking tackles down the way, took on a would-be defensive back, and finally the third Cardinal brought him down. He broke through three tackles on his way inside the 5. First and goal now from the 2. Mountaineers are ready. I formation, receiver right and a receiver left. Under center, Pat White takes a snap. Handoff, Slayton, he's in. Goal line, touchdown! West Virginia, Slayton scores from 2 yards away. 30-24, Mountaineers. And McAfee onto the field for the extra point try. West Virginia has just hit the magical 30-point mark. It's been a special number. And now McAfee will try the extra point. Tim Lindsay is the snapper, George Schell the holder. Ball back, kick goes up, and the kick is good. 31-24 Mountaineers. Under center goes Brian Brom. Two receivers to his right, one to his left. Snap, quick pass down. It is caught by Yerudia, immediately tackled. No gain on the play. Boo McClee made the stop. No gain for the redshirted freshman, Mario Yerudia. Second down and 10 coming up. We are in overtime. 31-24, West Virginia leading the Louisville Cardinals.
That was that three-step drop just to the hitch pass, and for some reason the receiver didn't go downfield. He caught it at the line of scrimmage. Great job defense, snapping to it, getting the tackle.
Second and 10, Tinch goes in motion from left to right. From the shotgun, snap comes back. Brom sets his feet. He throws over the middle. The pass is caught inside the 20, running to the 15, and Yerudia knocked out of bounds after picking up the first down at the 11-yard line. A gain of 14 on second down and 10. Yerudia picks up a first down. And the Cardinals will scrimmage from the 11-yard line.
That's that crossing pattern again, Tony, bringing him way across from underneath, clearing with inside receivers, bringing the wide man all the way underneath. Takes a while, but he had protection and he got to it.
Put the ball down officially at the 10. First down at the 10-yard line. Snap, handoff, Bush hit in the backfield. He'll get nothing going there. He'll lose a half a yard. Warren Young, playing in place of the injured Ernest Hunter, made the stop there on Michael Bush. The Cardinals can get a first down inside the 1-yard line. So call it second down and 10 for Louisville. The ball just outside of the 10. Empty backfield, five receivers going out. Brom ready from the shotgun. Snap back, he looks to his left, he throws, and the ball dropped and incomplete in the 5-yard line for Michael Bush. Underthrew him. Third down and 10 for the Cardinals. Overtime. Brom dropping back. Brom looks into the end zone, fires, caught, touchdown to Yerudia. And the Cardinals answer in overtime. Carmody ready for the extra point try. Snap comes back, the kick goes up, and the kick is good, and we will go to a second overtime session tied at 31.
Have you decided?
Sirloin steak fingers.
Whoa, Nelly! Mary, you just ordered yourself a Shoney's value basket. What's your game plan?
Well, I ordered the sirloin steak fingers, Keith. I'm gonna eat them.
Sounds good. What about defense?
Huh?
You gotta be ready. This lineup brings five great All-American baskets to the table.
I'm ready, Keith.
I'm ready! From burgers to chicken fingers, these value baskets are ready to be gobbled up. All for just $5.99. Hurry, because just like football season, they'll go away fast. For great food at a great price, it's down, set, Shoney's.
With a Prime Line home equity line of credit from United Bank, you can use the equity in your home to help you realize many of your life's plans. You get a great rate, and the interest may be tax deductible. See us today to learn more and make your plans accordingly. United Bank, West Virginia's home equity leader.
On any given day in West Virginia, there are enough West Virginia lottery ticket winners to fill Milan Pushcar Stadium at Mountaineer Field. That's approximately 60,000 winning tickets daily, 420,000 weekly, and more than 21 million every year. Get in the game with a West Virginia lottery. It could be your winning season.
Trying to pay off a high wireless bill is never pretty. Thankfully, there's Evo, the only phone with unlimited text messaging and free night and weekend calling that lets you decide how much to spend each month. Get the signal. Cellular One.
Today's game is brought to you by Shoney's. Enjoy Shoney's legendary breakfast buffet. It's a whole lot of food for your money. Shoney's. By West Virginia University Hospitals and Physicians, a better way to care. By Cellular One, get the signal. By Walker Machinery, coal keeps the lights on. And by Coca-Cola, you make the game.
And now the Cardinal offense will have possession of the football. Here we go. Tinch goes in motion to the left. And the snap, play action. Brom looking to his right, throws to his right, pass is caught by Tinch at the 15, and he will be knocked down after gaining the first down out of bounds on the far side at the 14, an 11-yard pickup. Almost intercepted, just threaded it in there, down to the 14 it goes.
So close is right, Tony. I thought we had it. He had a good angle on it, did a nice job reading it. But again, you give Brom credit because he had the smoke on that to get it in there.
First down and 10 from the 14-yard line. Here we are in overtime, number two, tied at 31. Three receivers right, and they hand off to Michael Bush, and Bush takes it to the 10, into the 5, end zone, touchdown, Louisville. Michael Bush from 14 yards away gives Louisville the lead. Now Carmody for the extra point try. Left-footed kicker out of Shreveport, Louisiana. Ball comes back and the kick goes up and it is good. And now the onus falls on West Virginia's offense. Here we go, first down and 10. From the 25-yard line in overtime, West Virginia down by 7. Shotgun formation with two receivers to the right and a single receiver, Raynaud, to the left. Shotgun snap comes back, quarterback run. Here's Pat White, takes the ball for 2 yards down to the 23-yard line. Time is of no consequence here. There is no play clock that runs during overtime. There is a play clock, obviously, but not a game clock. Ready to go. Second down and 8 for the Mountaineers. Two receivers to the left, Miles out to the right. Here's a snap, running option. Toss play goes to Steve Slayton. Slayton to the 20, takes it to the outside. 15, 10 down the sideline. 5, lunges for the end zone. He is in! Touchdown, Steve Slayton. He did it again. The freshman phenom took it down the left sideline on an option toss, and West Virginia is still alive. 38-37 in this second overtime. He has 183 rushing yards and 5
touchdowns.
Great job on the option. Good pitch by Pat White. Got a block there out of the wide receiver, and Steve made a miss. Nice job.
Here we go. Chance to tie it up. McAfee is ready. The ball goes up, and the kick is good. Oh, my gracious sakes alive, he almost missed it.
Pops, come get it.
I think that's a challenge.
Are you serious? I won't even put my bag down.
What?
Come on, man.
Don't let that man shoot.
You got nothing. You don't got nothing.
Oh. Oh.
Your mouth looks dry. Have a coke.
You know what that is? That's the rooftop, sir.
When we got married, suddenly we had two of everything.
They had a lot of stuff.
Two dining sets, two dogs.
Two car insurance companies.
I'm State Farm agent Joan Royceum, and this is a true story.
We had to get rid of a few things.
Yeah, mainly my things.
He had State Farm.
She had a gecko.
I helped them compare rates and coverage.
It was no comparison.
He was right, for once.
This time, one of my things stayed.
Like a good neighbor?
State Farm is there.
Brought to you by United Bank, leader of the free checking world.
Have you decided?
Sirloin steak fingers.
Whoa, Nelly! Barry, you just ordered yourself a Shoney's value basket. What's your game plan?
Well, I ordered the sirloin steak fingers, Keith. I'm gonna eat them.
Sounds good. What about defense?
Huh?
You gotta be ready. This lineup brings five great All-American baskets to the table.
I'm ready, Keith.
I'm ready!
From burgers to chicken fingers, these value baskets are ready to be gobbled up. All for just $5.99. Hurry, because just like football season, they'll go away fast. For great food at a great price, it's down, set, Shoney's.
West Virginia's offense gets the ball first here in this third overtime session, 38-38, and away we go. Shotgun, two receivers left and one out to the right. Pat White takes the snap, hands off to Slayton, tries the right side, looking for a seam, and will gain a couple of yards. Give him three, and make it second down and seven.
Got some guys walking slow on that defense right now, Tony. They've been out there a while.
Officially, they're going to give Steve Slayton 2 yards. Second down and eight from the right side hash mark. Backs are split, shotgun formation. And the snap comes back, play action. Pat White rolls, throws, incomplete. Under through Steve Slayton, and it will go to third down and eight. Third and eight coming up from the 23-yard line.
Just need four here. We got two downs to get it in.
Brandon Miles out to the right and two receivers out to the left on third down and eight. Once again, the backs are split out of the shotgun. Pat White looks over toward the West Virginia sideline. Play clock is down to six. White is ready. Here's the big third down play. He drops, blitz comes, he dumps the ball left flat, caught by Owen Schmidt. Here comes Schmidt. Schmidt inside the 15, takes it to the 10, keeps going to the 5. They wrestle him down inside the 5 at the 3. Owen Schmidt once again leaving Cardinals in his wake. It will be first and goal to go for West Virginia. A 20-yard catch and run for Owen Schmidt. His uniform, right shoulder full of red paint from those Cardinal helmets and jerseys that he's been ripping up. Great play call. First and goal to go from the three for the Mountaineers. We're in the third overtime, tied at 38. I formation for West Virginia. Receiver left and a receiver right. White takes the snap, hands off for Slayton. Slayton heading toward the end zone, pushing in. He'll get it to the one. A gain of two on first and goal from the three. Brad Palmer back up tight end into the game for the Mountaineers. I formation for West Virginia, double tight end, single receiver to the left, Jallo. On second and goal from the 1 yard line, Pat White barks out the signals, takes the snap from center Dan Moses, toss play, right side Slayton heading in, he is into the end zone, touchdown West Virginia. Slayton scores his sixth touchdown in the third overtime, and West Virginia takes a 44-38 lead, and the Mountaineers will have to go for two now in this third overtime. They will use a timeout. Steve Slayton has scored six touchdowns. West Virginia will take three receivers, tightly bunch them, and put them to the left. Brandon Miles, single receiver to the right. Owen Schmidt out of the gun. Here's the snap. Pat White rolling the pocket to the left, throws in the end zone. Pass caught. Two-point conversion good to Darrell Jallo. West Virginia hits on the conversion in the third overtime. And the Mountaineers take an eight-point lead, 46-38. Dwight, that was beautifully thrown, beautifully called. He was wide open, streaking in the back of the end zone.
I'll tell you what, if Pat White is not a pressure player, I've never seen one. Unbelievable. Kid comes off the bench, runs for all these yards. I'll tell you what, between he and Slayton, what a performance. And then add Schmidt, and plus the job we're doing up front now. I'll tell you what, this has been a great effort team-wise. Can't just give it to the offense because we've had everybody contribute, but now defense, it's in your court. Come on, guys.
46-38, overtime three. Louisville needs to score a touchdown and get a two-point conversion from the shotgun on first and 10. Brian Brom drops back, has time, dumps the ball right flat, caught by Michael Bush. Mike Lorello gets a hand on him, can't bring him down. Finally, they wrestle him down inside the 20 at the 19-yard line. A 7-yard gain, make it 6 yards on the catch and run upfield by Michael Bush.
They wanted to go to the crossing route, Tony, but one of our linebackers leveled the crossing route. Did a nice job. Brom came off to the swing, which was Bush. He was swinging out there to the right and caught that on the run. Bush made two or three of us miss, so our pursuit saved us on that one.
6 yard gain, second down and four from the 19 yard line. Mountaineers lead by 8 points in overtime number three. Three receivers left, two to the right. Brom from the shotgun takes the snap, drop, pressure over the middle. The pass is caught inside the 10 is Tinch, and he will take the ball down to the 3 yard line. Joshua Tinch gives Louisville a first down and goal at the 3 yard line, a 16 yard reception. Jay Henry makes the tackle, and the ball is right dab smack in the middle of the field between the two hash marks.
They like Tinch, I'll guarantee you. Tinch is their guy they're gonna go to whenever they can. And
keep in mind, a fumble would end this game. West Virginia by eight. Single setback is Bush, two wings. Now the wing to the left goes in motion to the right. And Brom takes the snap, hands off to Bush. He will be stonewalled and left short. Did not make it. It will be second down, and they'll put him down at the 3 yard line. No gain on that play.
Good job up front. Really did a nice job as a line of scrimmage. We got a little push in there and then got good. Everyone filled gaps. Nice gap control defense there. And a lot of people straining, because when Bush hits it up in there and gets nothing, you know you've got a lot of folks doing the job they're supposed to do.
46-38, we are in the third overtime. West Virginia leads by eight. Second and goal from the three. I formation, wingman in motion from left to right. Brom under his center, takes the snap, handoff to Bush running off the left side, and he will be in for the touchdown from 3 yards away. And now the Cardinals must convert the two-point try or West Virginia will win the game. It's 46-44 West Virginia, and it will come down to a play to see if this game will go to a fourth overtime or if it will come to an end. Mountaineer faithful on their feet. A sea of gold waving here. Cardinals break from their huddle. They're going to go with the empty backfield. Five receivers going out. Brom, the quarterback, is ready. Here comes the try for two. He has the snap. He drops. He looks. Pressure collapses. He's running, and he will be stopped short. They've tackled him. The ball game is over. The West Virginia University Mountaineers have rallied to defeat the Louisville Cardinals in one of the greatest games in West Virginia football history. The Mountaineers prevail 46-44. It is a great night to be a Mountaineer wherever you may be. It's over in Morgantown. They've come back from 24-7 down to win it 46-44. They went with the empty set. Brian Brom, the quarterback, dropped, nowhere to throw it. He started to run. He was hit at the 5-yard line. He went down to the 3, and Eric Wicks brought him down, and the Mountaineers have knocked off the 19th rated Cardinals 46-44. Oh my gracious sakes alive.
This is MSN, the Mountaineers Sports Network.